Rand here, and well, let's just say I've been busy doing cotton, or at least the hired workers have anyway. Got almost two full loads of bales here on this little bit OP game mods cotton bale auto load trailer here. Got a total of 20 bales on this one here, and I think I'm three short. Yeah, three short bales here for the second load. So we got a bunch of cotton bales. And, of course, all this cotton came off of fields 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And then I did do 8, 9, 10, 11 twice, I think. Basically, for those of you watching the John Deere 2510 tractor rebuilds, I basically set the hired workers loose on the field, and I went out and rebuilt the tractor while the hired workers harvested cotton. Actually, you know what? Can I tab to my cotton harvester here? We got almost 20 hours on the cotton harvester, and yes, most of that came off of probably this field here. And keep in mind, I had a leased harvester. Actually, I already returned that. I probably should have kept it just to see how many hours were on that, but I forgot to do that. I returned that one already. So yes, two harvesters harvesting the cotton. And yeah, the first harvester there, the one we own, has 20 hours on it already. Keep in mind that all wasn't from just these two harvests here, but that's where most of it came from. So we'll see if we can safely transport this down to the sell point here. If you notice, I don't know why, but for some reason when it filled up, it's now, I don't know, like not sitting on the trailer right. I'm not sure what's up with that. But anyway, actually, you know what? What is the price for cotton here? Cotton is, and actually, you know what? I just realized something too. I would have actually had, oh, it's actually not that great a price at the moment, is it? We probably really should wait, really. Okay, well, we might be able to do that. Maybe I'll just park this tractor down here. We got a couple fields that need to be replanted and all that good stuff as well. And I think, should we go this way maybe? I mean, I don't know if this way is any worse than the other way, so. But yeah, suffice to say, I think I've had enough cotton here for a little bit. I do actually probably plan on replanting 4 and 5 and cotton again, though. Like I said, cotton, it's in some ways really easy to do, especially with this auto load trailer. This is definitely OP. But basically just, you know, hire the worker and let him go. Like I said, I was working out in the shop all day, and the hired worker was pretty much harvesting cotton. Well, I'm actually not sure how long it took him. I mean, it took him a while, but I don't think there's any collision on these bales, by the way, so we should be able to, you know, go through whatever. There's something above us. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going to leave this parked here for the moment. And like I said, hopefully maybe the price on cotton will go up here eventually. I'm hoping anyway. Let's see, anything else has changed since last episode? I don't think so, really. Pretty much just been harvesting a lot of cotton, I believe. Oh, I have put up some silos here. I don't believe I showed all this here on screen. I do have a couple of silos up here. I'm probably actually going to sell this one, move it over here, and then put, I think I'm missing the lime silo. Yeah, I'm missing the lime silo. I'm probably going to put the lime silo where this one is. Trying to strategically lay out where I have the silos here so I don't have overlapping fill types. And what I mean by that is if I pull up with a planter and I want to fill the planter with seeds and fertilizer, I don't have the seeds and fertilizer next to each other, so it can potentially, you know, not fill the proper one. I'm gonna try to have them separated, so that's why I have, you know, herbicide is here, and then I'm thinking I'm probably gonna put the liquid. This one's the liquid here, right? Yeah, this is the liquid. I'm probably gonna put that one here, so they're still separated by one, so I shouldn't be able to accidentally fill with liquid fertilizer when I went herbicide. And then I'll put the lime, and I don't want, the reason I want to move this one is I don't want the lime next to the fertilizer here, so I accidentally fill with fertilizer when I want lime. Hopefully that makes sense. So that's why I want to move that one over. But yeah, anyway, like I said, we got lots of fields that need to be replanted here. Silos, I don't believe I've changed that at all. I did, what was it? We were picking up straw there last episode. I did fill the straw barn here. I filled it up, and then that was all the straw I bothered taking the time to get. I didn't bother getting any more straw. So this thing here is full. Be nice if you'd actually could see like a fill level on it. I don't think you can that I know of. Oh well, that'd be kind of nice if you could, but yeah, we do have that full of straw. Never did fix the water tank yet. I'll have to do that sometime. Probably just like lower it, sell it and lower it back down. It's not that expensive. So Yeah. Anyway, let's get started on replanting here. These fields, looks like they're good to just start planting. So, like I said, cotton on 4 and 5. Let's grab the 8370RT here. Still hooked up to the DB90 and actually full of seed too. Yeah, probably should put some fertilizer in it here first before we head out. Not entirely sure what to do with the combines yet. It's like, what shed do I put these in? Again, the headers on these don't have the trailer part on them, so I can't just, you know, unhook them, set them on the ground, and then, you know, put them wherever we want. It's, you know, pretty much set them on the ground, and that's where they're going to have to stay, so. Oh, there we go. Now it's filling. Just a reminder here, too, by the way, for anybody watching, if you'd like to join us on the multiplayer servers, again, that information is in the description below. We ask that you please just join us on TeamSpeak. Again, anyone's welcome to join as long as you can play nicely and follow the rules. And I noticed here, this object here is, does not get dirty, does it? The rest of this planter gets, like, horribly dirty. Don't particularly care for that myself. I mean, like I said before, it looks like you dragged this planter through the mud. And it's, yeah, just ugly. But let's head out to field 4 and 5 here. Don't remember if I think I showed that on screen, right? I combined 4 and 5 into one field now. You can watch it. It doesn't need lime, does it? Hey, yeah, that one little section does. We'll wait till the rest of the field needs it, then we'll do the entire thing. And obviously, I haven't really done much more with terraforming here yet. We're a little on the broke side. Though we do have a lot of collateral sitting in the cotton bales here at the moment, or cotton modules, whatever you want to call them. Just going to maybe probably wait for the price to go up just a little bit, because, yeah, $3,600, I believe that's on the low side. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong on that. I believe it can go like $4,000-something. And I believe someone even left in the comments they've seen it as high as $5,000, and I probably won't wait for it to go that high. I mean, it'd be great if it did, but I'll definitely, I'll take $3,600. I'm not going to complain with that, but, you know, if it can go up to $4,000-something, that'll be even better yet. And total, I actually had a total of 40 bales, I believe it was. I did actually sell 3 bales. I had to sell 3 bales so I could replant the cotton the second time around. Otherwise, I was out of money and was unable to replant my fields. Because, again, once you run out of money, you cannot refill the seeder. I could have switched it over so you can buy the fertilizer and all that good stuff. But it's like, you know what, we'll just sell a couple cotton bales here. Like I said, I think I sold 3 of them. So, yeah, otherwise, I would have actually had 2 full loads. And I believe I sold those for probably $4,000-something a piece. That's probably why the prices dropped down. I sold 3 bales already. Although that's a little bit annoying. You know, you sell 3 bales and the price drops already. It's like, really? Oh, yeah, and I do have a lime silo sitting down here. I don't remember if I showed that or not. Got a lime silo sitting there. I'm probably going to, like, you know, strategically, randomly, place silos like that around the map here. Especially for the lime, because it goes so quickly. Okay, we'll just hire the worker here. And, yep, saving content. Nice, nice. Yeah, he should be good to go. So let's grab our challenger. I'm not sure where I left the challenger at. I guess we're going to figure this out here. Where's the challenger at? Oh, wait. I think I seen him over here. There he is. Sitting in front of the shop. But yeah, so far I'm liking how this kind of farmyard area here is turning out. Definitely, again, plan on doing more with it. But, yeah, I need some funds to do so at this point. Oh, and of course, with that much cotton harvesting going on, lots and lots of repair to the cotton harvesters, including the least one, by the way. I think I repaired the least one twice, I'd like to say. And I repaired the cotton harvester we own probably 3 times. So, yeah, just to give everyone... The cotton harvester must not have a very long maintenance time on it or something, because, again, you know, it's only got 20 hours on it, and like I said, I've already maintained it, I think, three times, and in addition to whatever I've maintained it already to yet. So I don't know if I've maintained it before this or not, but just for these two harvests, I have maintained it three times. Seems a little bit ridiculous and excessive to me, but... And I know at least the one time it was completely out of maintenance, like 0% on the bar there. It was completely used. Okay, what do we got you set on? Soybeans? Do we want to do soybeans? Do we want to do something? Actually, you know what? We probably should do something with straw, shouldn't we? Yeah, except I don't know. Do I want a field this big with straw on it? Oh, boy. Oh, let's see. So what do we have here? Wheat, barley. We could do some oats again. I think it's been a while since we've done oats, hasn't it? So yeah, with the money we're going to be getting off those cotton bales, hopefully it'll be a small fortune, hopefully anyway. Plan on probably purchasing 6, 12, and 13 with that money. I don't know if I have enough to get all three of these fields, but maybe I'll at least get like 6 and 12 for starters or something like that. We'll go from there. And then, of course, also I want to get some horses as well. I have not purchased any horses yet, so definitely want to get some horses purchased. There we go. And I don't know, debating here if I should combine 6 and 12, or I'm thinking maybe make like 6 a nice hay field. And I don't think we need that big of a hay field, so that's why I don't want to combine 6 and 12 together. I'm thinking maybe leaving 6 separate, that'll be a nice hay field, and then 12 and 13, I could probably combine those together, and that'll just hopefully make a nice field as well. And before I forget here, I want to do a little field removal here. So we're going to head over to landscaping mode, start landscaping. Both this field and the one over here, I want to remove just a little bit. Maybe not all of this angled section, but definitely want to remove a bit here because the hired worker really struggles with this. And I'm sick of having to fix them all the time. So... Let's switch that to that. Change landscaping mode. We want painting. And I also would like to have the shape. Yes, let's go to the square. And then ground type. Let's try to get some grass here. Is that the grass? Actually, this one has... we'll just go with the regular grass. That'll work. How about we start probably up here, so maybe... And yeah, we're just going to, I know we're losing a little bit of field here, but again, in the interest of making this a little easier, the hired worker does not like this portion of the field. Same thing on 8, 9, 10, and 11 there. We're going to do a little bit on that end of the field there as well, just to make it a little easier for the hired worker. And as I've said before, the one thing I don't like about this is the fact it takes the grass, the actual grass away. I mean, yes, it has a green texture, but... Be nice if you could actually have the grass yet. There we go. That takes care of that. And I'll just keep an eye on that, see how the hired worker does. You know, if we got to remove a little more, you know, one more width, I'm definitely okay with that. And then we're going to do the same thing over here as well. What do you think? Maybe start... Whoa, okay, that's... Nope, okay. Because it's in the ground, I'm not going to see where it is, am I? And why does that look like so much bigger than it really is? Yeah, Yeah, of course, if I want to make this back into a field, I can just plow it here again. Somebody did suggest I could maybe put some pastures over here. Don't know if there's going to be enough space for that or not. There might actually be. There might be. We'll have to see once here. We can maybe use this land for something. There we go. Okay, and then rid of that there. It actually worked up pretty good with a cotton harvester for this. The cotton harvester didn't seem to mind, but again, because it's a little bit narrower implement, narrow implements work okay on odd-shaped fields, I guess you could say. Or where the angles are more severe. Not enough money to make this modification. Whoa, I'm out of money? Whoa. Oops. My bad. I did not realize painting terrain was costing us that much because we just spent $90,000. Note to self, I could probably have cheaper purchased. Actually, I don't really well. Yeah, yes and no. There is also... Where is it here? No, not levelers. It's under miscellaneous, right? Metal roller. This machine, you can restore the initial ground state, delete fields. I could have bought that for $16,000, I guess. No GPS mod, though, so I think I'll just spend the extra money not doing it the way we're doing it. Why did you miss that there? That's odd. How's the cotton price looking? Because I'm thinking at this point we probably should sell some. Yeah, it hasn't changed, has it? Yeah, but why did you miss that? Weird. Oh, well. Whatever. Let's see once here. What else do we have going on? Not a whole lot, really. Pretty much need to let the hired workers do their thing here, I guess. I should probably start moving some of our equipment over into the sheds. Or shed, in this case. I do have the one shed up by the horses there. I figured I'd probably try to like keep the stuff for the horses up there, like water tank and stuff like that, maybe. Speaking of water tank, I don't think I've purchased one yet, have I? I didn't have to do that here yet. And also, again, you know, need to figure out what I'm going to do with the combines here. Figure out what shed would be good for them. Contact. Okay, we'll go grab the other one here. And I had purchased the other tractor there, by the way, the 6R, to pull that second lime spreader. That was the reason for that tractor. Also, definitely thinking the biogas factory here would definitely be another nice purchase. We'll have to see how much we get from the cotton there, I guess. Okay, not exactly straight. Close enough. Close enough. Oh, let's see. 40, 60. You know what? We could probably just go ahead and sell this particular spreader at the moment. That'll give us a little money here, too, won't it? We'll just unload this here. I know it's not completely empty. I've kind of been waiting for it to like get completely empty, but it takes quite a while. With the fertilizer spreader, fertilizer lasts quite a while, so hopefully if I dump it back here, I'll remember it's back there. Let's take this down to the shop here. The dual axle spreader, I believe, is up by other silos there. Watch, I'm actually thinking I'm probably going to sell those as well and move them. The hired worker does not appreciate these silos that are over right here, and might move them to the deleted section of the field over here, which, wow, I deleted a lot of field there. Eh, I might replow some of that. Might. I wasn't actually intended on removing that much. I was thinking about half that much, but, yeah, well. Not like we're hurting for fields here at this point. And for those who wonder, no, I still have not refueled this tractor yet, by the way. I have not refueled it at all. I don't know if that's costing us any money or not with the game having to put fuel in it all the time. Not entirely sure how that works. But for anybody wondering, if you do run out of fuel, obviously one, you can refuel it, you know, buy a fuel tanker, refuel it that way. Or you could just save the game, exit, and re-enter the save game, and then the save game automatically adds a little bit of fuel. Like I said, I don't know if that costs any money or not, but re-adds a little bit of fuel back into the tractor. And I've actually never—I don't think I've ever actually ran out of fuel yet. The amount of work I've put on this tractor, it's never ran out of fuel. You know, every time I guess I don't play long enough for the little bit of fuel it puts back in to be completely used up. Let's see, 94.2 hours on this tractor so far, adding up. Okay, we'll just sell you for $5,000. So yeah, you're not worth a whole lot, are you? Boy, oh well. Oh, that money did not last long, did it? Yep, I'm probably going to have to sell something. Either sell one of the cotton bales at a little bit lower price, or... what do I have? I think I've got a couple loads of oats in the silo. We could probably sell at least a load of oats. Seeing as how I don't have any horses yet, and we're planting an entire field of them. Selling some oats is not going to hurt us. That's probably what we're going to do. Yeah, let's sell some oats here. Get ourselves back a little more in the positive. Seems like a good plan to me anyway. And then if we make enough money off that, we can finish our field deletion as well. And before we wrap it up here for this episode, let's see if we can read a few quick comments here. I know we don't have a whole lot of time left, but... let's see. J. Robin was saying, if you turn the lime off in the settings, do you still get the plus 15% yield bonus as if it was on? I believe you do, yes. So if you turn it off... you still get the bonus even though you have not had to put the lime on, as far as I know. The same, I think, goes for herbicide and weeds as well. Obviously, you got the weeds off. And weeds are never going to show up, so it shouldn't take away from the bonus you get from that. But that's to my knowledge anyway. Simon was saying... on Hobbs Farm, I downloaded this map about 18 months ago. Still playing it today. Love the wooded area in the bottom right. Has made me a fortune turning it into wood chips. Awesome map. Wow. Still playing Hobbs Farm. A decent enough map there, I guess. Marhoof was asking, have you thought about streaming on Facebook? I have thought about it, yes. Not entirely sure what would all be involved in doing so, but... Okay, what's the chances I can get this backed in the shed here as well? Nope. That's a header. And maybe I'll just leave this outside the shed for now. Like I said, definitely need to figure out what I'm going to do with those combines there. Look through the shed options here at some point. Oh, let's grab the truck here. And as I was saying, let's sell some oats here real quick. Actually unload something from our silos here for the first time. We haven't been putting some stuff in the silos. Haven't taken anything out yet, so... Jedi Killer was saying, I guess now that you have the big fields, it's time to buy 6, 12, and 13. As I was mentioning a few moments ago, yes, that is going to be the plan. And then 6 probably would make a nice hay field, at least that's what I'm thinking anyway. Well, you'll have to see once as time goes on here how that field's going to handle. I mean, if we need a bigger field or small, I don't know. We'll find out, I guess. There we go. Okay, we should have some oats in here. Yes, we do. 108,000. Actually, almost 2 trailer loads. Steven was saying it's a bit OP, but you can fit 20 cotton bales on that auto load trailer. Yeah, that's just a bit OP. Very bit OP. John Doe was saying, deceptive practices equals your plain farming simulator. Why did you not fill? There it goes. The warlords at YouTube will kill it, for sure. You never know. They're working on it, probably, I guess. Working on it. Shelly was saying, liking the farm a lot. Well, hey, thank you very much for that. Yes, I'm assuming you're talking about the farmyard here. I'm liking how it's turning out here as well. Definitely have a little more work to do to it yet. But we'll keep going on it as the funds become available. Let's see. So, oats. Port grain. Really, the port grain elevator? Like my least favorite sell point. I don't know why. It is, for some reason, my least favorite sell point. Still need to do a little painting in front of our shed here yet. And of course need to finish leveling out around some of the areas here as well. Definitely have not done. And also there's like this one random spot in the middle of the field. I'm not sure how I did that. Ooh. Ian was saying you should really enable the inspector mod for the save game, and great video. Thank you very much for that. Yes, I keep forgetting to enable the inspector mod. I also have the keyboard steer mod. I forget to enable that one as well. I think it was keyboard steering? Something like that. I forget the exact name of the mod here now. It's basically a GPS-like mod. Not the GPS mod, but it's something similar. It's like a really basic version of the GPS mod. Let's see what's here. What is the ETA on course play? I really need it. Course play is probably still going to be, if I had to guess, a month or two out yet. Just my theory. I know it's in testing at the moment, so you never know. From what I've heard, though, sounds like lots of bugs, which, I mean, doesn't really surprise me, given everything that Giants has supposedly changed with the game. Oh, yeah, this is definitely getting us back in the positive here. Can I finish my landscaping here real quick? Oops, got off by one there. Oh, well. Off by more. Oh, boy. That end of the field got a little messed up. Oops. Kind of hard to tell where it's at there, unfortunately. Okay, there we go. Yeah, like I said, this end of the field needs a little help, but hopefully the hired workers won't mind that too much there. That definitely straightens that end of the field out. If we check it out on the map, like I said, it took off a little more than I was actually planning on doing there. I was thinking about half that. But that's not going to hurt none. I think the rest of the field here should actually be pretty good. Hired worker definitely doesn't like this part of the field down here either. So I don't know, maybe in the future we'll take a little bit off there. Or, I don't know, we'll have to do something. And as I mentioned as well, I should really sell the silos that are over there now that we have them kind of down by our main farmyard area. And then we also have that spot on the opposite side of the field too. Maybe I can put up like a lime and seed fertilizers. We shouldn't need everything over there, but put up a couple silos over there as well. Anyway, on that note, everyone, I think we're going to wrap it up here for this episode. If you folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching, and until next time.